looking to get open in the middle of the field. It's the Bills going up against the Patriots. Now let's head down to Jim Nantz and Phil Sims for this week 2 matchup.
It's the NFL on EA Sports. Two AFC East teams about to collide as we join you from Ralph Wilson Stadium. Hello, friends. Jim Nantz along with Phil Sims, and welcome to this heated divisional rivalry. Yes, there have been a lot of close games, a lot of bad blood, and it's always intense when these two get ready to square off. How about it before kickoff, partner?
Well, you said it all, didn't you? Close games, heated rivalry. That alone tells you how exciting this game is going to be. When you take good players on two teams and you put them in the same division, oh my gosh, look out. That's when you get exciting physical football, and I think that's what we'll see here.
The Bills are ready to run back this kick. This game is underway. Harvin on the return. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. Taylor's going to be the one leading this offense today. Last week he accounted for over 200 yards passing. McCoy lines up in the backfield. The Bills take it from the 28. McCoy's tackle right at the 28. Here's the Bills offense. A coach's dream a week ago, as this team never turned over the football once. An extra tight end on the field for this one. Percy Harvin has the catch. Butler's the one who brings him to the ground. He is a former first-round pick of the Patriots, Devin McCourty.
Devin McCourty has shown everybody what a player he is on the defensive side. He's played corner, he's played safety, and man, the guy is smart. You put it all together, you have an all-pro.
The Bills have a third down coming up. They did a great job a week ago of converting on third down. Taylor's got it in the gun. And this will be incomplete. It'll be a three and out.
Watkins is one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
Edelman with the fair catch signal here as he won't return this one. Brady's going to jog out to the huddle now. Coming off a strong performance where he threw 4 touchdown passes.
It's pretty amazing what Tom Brady has done in his career. Every single year, he just puts up outstanding numbers. And every year, his touchdown to interception ratio seems to get better.
First down at the 20. Powell's going to make the tackle. And now a look at the Patriots' offense. Last week, they never turned the football over once. And it's now second down and 5 after running it on first down. They need to get the playoff. Brady from the gun. LaFell comes away with the reception. And he's tackled down at the 36-yard line.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
First down at the 36. And the tackle is made at the 41.
So many times you watch football games and coaches just give up too early on the run game. Well, they'll keep it going today after that run. Decent pickup by the running back.
Double tight end formation. The play clock's running down. Scott Chandler has the grab.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
First down here after the completion.
Brady goes to the ground. Gronkowski with the catch.
And now we'll take a look at the Bills' defense. They know they need to force turnovers today, coming off a game in which they had no takeaways. Pass complete, but did not get them the first, so it's second down now. Two tight ends on the field here. Here's the handoff to LeGarrette Blount. And that'll gain just a few yards.
Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short gain.
Third down following the run. Handoff out of the eye. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Jackson's able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
The Patriots at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. The Patriots have it at the 39. And it's hauled in by Edelman. And that's a gain of 10. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
Man, he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
And it's over to Gronkowski with the catch. He's brought down at the 23-yard line.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
The Patriots take it from the 23.
Jackson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back, but there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
They better hurry to get the snap. They call his name again. Brown's there to make the tackle.
Third short, I don't know what you do anymore. I've given up. Do you throw it? Do you run it? Do you have that kind of faith in your offensive line? Well, the offense does. They run the football. Great job by the offensive lineman, giving that running back a chance to get that first down.
And he finds Scott Chandler. Patriots in the end zone. Chandler's caught his first touchdown of the season. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The Bills are ready to return the kickoff. Harvin's got a chance for a return. And the tackle's made right around the 26-yard line. The Bills weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive play.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
It's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses.
First first down and 10. LeSean McCoy takes the handoff.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
The Bills take it from the 33. McCoy up the middle.
The NFL, it's so hard in these known situations. Second down and short is a big running down in the NFL. The defense knew it. They took advantage of it and stopped the offense for no gain.
Third down and 2. McCoy is taking the handoff.
And this fires the football team up. The defense, third and short, they stop the run. Keeps the offense short of the first down, and look at the excitement on the defensive side.
The field goal attempt is good. It's good. As we edge closer to the second quarter, they edge a little closer on the scoreboard with the successful kick.
Yeah, that was good for the team. It was a big confidence boost, and now they know they can do it on the offensive side, and now it's up to the defense to keep this thing going.
The Bills' defense comes back onto the field. Did not look so good that last series, giving up the touchdown.
Oh, you know the coaches are upset. My gosh, they ran some of the most elementary defenses that you could run, and they had mistakes by the defensive players. And they coach them up on the sidelines. We'll see if we see different results. If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Play clock's running down. Here's the handoff. Picks up 8 here.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second and 2. Got it. First down. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play.
Wide receivers in the NFL, hey, they can catch it, but also they can break tackles. What a job that time by the wide receiver.
It's a 2 tight end formation. First down at the 44. Brady throws it into the big mitts of Rob Gronkowski. Third catch today so far.
This tight end's very talented. He's a good run blocker and also a good receiver. Makes a nice catch on that throw.
The line of scrimmage, the 32-yard line.
Trying to beat the play clock. Brady standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Had it for just a second, but then it came out on contact.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close. So he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocks the football out to the ground.
This defense is ready to pounce here early in this game as a third and long play is coming up.
They sure are. There's no doubt about that. They got themselves in a good situation here. If I'm the quarterback now, third long, I would be very cautious and conservative.
One quarter complete. And defense has been the story thus far. Back after this. We're back here to start the second quarter. And partner, when you're in a tight defensive game like this, what does an offense have to do to open this game up?
Well, I think what happens sometimes in situations like this, Jim, you know, the offense, they plan for the game and what they're going to do, but they come out there and then that first series or two and they go, wow, these guys are better in person than they were on the film. So you've got to adjust physically. I think now that they have adjusted, we'll see if they can make some things happen. Now look at all these great tight ends in the NFL now. Makes me think of the NBA. These are power forwards who said, to heck with that. They want to be pass catchers, and they're good at it.
Rob Gronkowski with the grab.
The Bills' defensive coordinator made the right call that time. In the red zone, he was expecting pass. That's what he got, and they get up there, and they make the tackle quickly after the pass completion.
Brady's completion percentage, 90% on the day.
He's hit as he throws it. That's what's expected in the NFL nowadays from the players, especially these receivers. They're so aggressive, so athletic. They go all out for every catch. That time, he just lets it all go. Not able to make the catch, but I'll give him an A for effort.
The catch is made by Edelman.
Touchdown, New England Patriots.
That's his first touchdown catch of the season. Their lead grows a little more with that touchdown, and still a long way to go in this half. They may be able to add even more to it before the break.
Jim, I don't see anything that's going to slow them down. Everything they are trying is working. They have been spectacular here so far today, and all I can say to the opponents, you better buckle up. This is going to be tough.
Brady certainly given his team some momentum with that scoring drive. He just put together a possession where he threw for more than 60 yards. Steven Gostkowski's readying his team for the kickoff. That's a touchback, and the ball will be spotted at the 20. Devin McCourty taking the field once again. Their defense has had a lot to do with them getting out to this lead, and he's been the one setting the tone, Phil.
Yeah, Jim, I love the way he plays. He's had a terrific day so far. His toughness, I think that's his greatest quality.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. First down at the 20. The Bills run the risk right now of having to abandon the running game. McCoy's been off the mark, and that's a big reason why they're trailing in this one.
That's right. It hasn't worked. So what do you say? Don't be afraid to change. What you have to do, you call the plays. They give your team the best chance to win, and they better start changing those play calls.
He's going to be tackled right around the 21-yard line.
The Patriots guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
Taylor's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Scanning the field. And he's going to be dropped for the sack, and they're going to be punting after a short series.
Well, that time the quarterback is sacked on the third down, and that's, of course, that's bad. But the good thing is he did not try to force the football down the field and get the turnover.
They're in punting formation. Edelman, he'll return this one and pick up about four. The Patriots' offense, Phil, is on a roll right now with touchdowns coming on each of their last two possessions. Can they make it three in a row right here?
Well, we're going to find out. I like their chances. What have we seen that makes us think that they're not going to come out there and get it done? They're playing exceptional football on the offensive side.
First down at the 48. They'll mark him at the 46.
This is one good tackling defense. They stay in good position at all times, and we saw it that time, and they stopped the play for a short game.
Second and 8. Blunt. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
They need to get the playoff. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
Well, Jim, that's a nice job by the defender knocking that football down on third down. That's what you want to do as a defense. Of course, you want to get off the field. Every time an offense completes a third down pass, their chances of getting a score on that drive go up big time. So getting off the field is great. Nice job by the defender.
And he punts it, and it's going to sail out of bounds, trying to play kick away from that dangerous returner. And there is LeSean McCoy. He hasn't made much of an impact in this game, Phil, and that's caused problems for his side.
Yeah, listen, he is the center of their football team. When he goes well, of course, the team goes well. So they've got to find a way to get him started. How do you do that? Is it a trick?
Intercepted!
And he's brought to the ground.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Patriots offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard so you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling.
Brady's all by himself in the backfield for this snap.
Brady's going to take it from the gun. Gronkowski has it. Touchdown, New England.
It was a short route by the receiver. He catches it and goes all the way down the field and scores a touchdown. And the quarterback looks at the coach and goes, hey, it was a heck of a throw.
The Bills now have even more work to do to get back into this one. Scores 21-3. That'll be a touchback, and the ball will be placed at the 20. A look at Chandler Jones right there. He's been the leader for them in what's been a terrific defensive effort up to this point, partner.
And you know what he does? He brings energy to the defense. There's no question about that, and I love the way he plays. It just rubs off on all of his teammates.
They try to convince them otherwise, but that's a false start on the offense.
False start, offense.
Taylor's got two tight ends on the field for this snap.
McCoy.
Ninkovich is the one who made the big stop.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
The Bills lined up, bunch formation. McCoy has the grab.
Well, the most common thing that most offensive coordinators do in the NFL on third and long situations, they're going to call a play where they probably don't think they're going to pick up the first down, but they're looking for field position.
Stands in the pocket. Got drilled as he throws it.
The Bills put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
All set to punt here. Edelman, he'll return this one. That's a gain of 8. The Patriots have looked terrific on offense. Brady's been airing it out and finding the end zone.
Yeah, he has been right on target, pinpoint with those passes, and he is the main reason they're winning this game here today.
Gun. Brady finds Gronkowski.
And Williams is in on the tackle, creating space and being a big target. That's what we've seen out of this guy today, Phil.
No doubt about it. He is a talented tight end. In the NFL, the coaches are doing a better and better job of finding ways to get tight ends more chances to catch the football. And this guy's taking advantage of it so far here today.
Edelman with the reception. The Patriots are up right now, and credit goes to the quarterback here, partner. Brady's been in rhythm so far today.
He has been in rhythm. He is hot. Some days, Jim, when you warm up, you know you have it, and that's what happened to this guy today. When he was warming up, he had it, and he has it in the game. When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The play clock's running down. Here's the handoff to LeGarrette Blount. And he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line.
That's not a good job by the running back. Play the situation. It's second and short. Get the first down. He makes a bad decision, gets tackled short. And now we got a tough third down coming up.
Third and one. Jackson Scott on the handoff. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Jackson's able to get it done that time. Why? Because he has the power and the will to make it happen. Third short, he just gets it done with sheer willpower.
Blount taken down at the 27.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stopped him for a short gain.
Coming to the line at the 27. The Bills lined up in the nickel. They better hurry to get the snap. Brady connects with Gronkowski.
Well, these tight ends in the NFL now, they make the catches down the field. They're fast. They can do it all. And everybody is looking for that all-in-one, a guy that can block at the line of scrimmage, who can catch the football well, and has the speed to make it happen once he catches it.
Brady's now completed 4 in a row.
The quarterback should have never thrown at that time. Even though he completes the pass, he should have seen the defense was right there, a loss of a couple yards.
And we've reached the 2-minute warning in this one. We're back, and we're coming out of the 2-minute warning in the first half. Second and 11. He's wide open for the grab.
Situations you go over so many times in practice and training camp. Know what's going on the offensive side, how to preserve time. Good job that time by the offensive player. Get out of bounds and give his team more chances to get it done here in the first half.
They are staring at the end zone just a yard away. That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line. Patriots in for the score. He has just cracked the 400 mark in his remarkable career with that touchdown pass.
Hard to cover these tight ends when they get into the end zone because they're fast, they're nimble, and they're big. So even if you cover them, they push off and get the touchdown catches.
And a touchback here will bring the ball out to the 20. The Bills. Phil, what's the issue with this team? This offense specifically. 3 straight drives without a score.
Well, Jim, I'd say this. It's bad coaching. I just hate what they're trying to do on the offensive side. They're not putting their players in position to give them a chance to compete against this defense. They've got to change things up, give their offense a chance, and give these players a chance.
Taylor's back in shotgun formation. Woods with the catch. It's Rob Ninkovich who makes the tackle. After the pass play, gain 7. Second and 3 on the way. Hurry up. 2-minute offense. Got a flag. Robert Woods with the reception.
Offside. Defense.
Bill declined the penalty and let the play stand.
Let's round. Let's round.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Scans the field, and it's caught by LeSean McCoy. And now they'll try over again on second down. No time to huddle now. Taylor's got it in the gun. Looking at every option. Finds his mark. And that picks up three. It's third down coming up. Taylor standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Almost intercepted. We're nearing the half, and in the locker room at halftime, this offense is going to have to adjust.
Well, they better make some adjustments, and I'll just say this to them and to the whole football team. It's not about winning the game. It's just about playing hard and doing the right thing now. Don't look at the scoreboard, and if you get some breaks and you play great, maybe then you'd have a chance to get back into this game.
The Patriots have had a smart and snappy first half, and that's reflected on the scoreboard.
Sounds like the way I dress, smart and snappy. That is me. But, you know, hey, it's been a good first half for the offense. They want to keep it going. I'm sure they will.
Brady's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Gronkowski hauls in that bullet pass. The Patriots call a timeout. Their first. The Bills defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Gronkowski hauls in that bullet pass. The Patriots will use a timeout here. They'll talk it over before running a play on first down. First down on the way. This play set up by the long gainer. Snap back to Brady from the gun. Brady finds Gronkowski. The Patriots moving inside the 20 and the red zone. Last week, they just feasted on that part of the field. Brady is in the shotgun. Interception. No one's going to get him now. He's at the 50, the 40, the 30, the 20, the 10, and he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
You got to love that from your defense. They take a chance. They get the interception. Not only do they do that, they return it a long way for the touchdown.
The teams head to the locker room, and we'll be heading to the studio to our pal Larry Ridley as you watch the NFL on EA Sports. The second half has officially started, and are we going to see a big-time comeback? And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. When one quarterback plays well and the other doesn't, that can lead to a pretty one-sided affair like we've had here today.
Yeah, it has been one-sided, but look, there's always reasons why a quarterback plays well or doesn't. Jim, it truly is a team game on the offensive side, and the good numbers come from the offensive line that played well, and the bad numbers come from an offensive line that really struggled here today.
The Patriots have created chances for themselves in the passing attack today. Brady's done everything he can to keep his team on top.
He has been so efficient here today, very smart, making decisions. And when you put those two things together, that's why your football team is winning.
He's going to be tackled right around the 42-yard line. Tight end has not been a problem lately. This guy, as you can see by the numbers, continues to thrive.
He's one of the best in the NFL, isn't he? And every week he just finds a way to get it done from the tight end position.
Easy catch there. No one near him. The Patriots know they have one of the best QBs in the league, and it's showing up in the stat sheet these last 2 weeks. Brady's coming up with big numbers back-to-back weeks.
Well, I think he knows this offense is all about him. The play designs are there for him. The offensive line, they built it to protect him. And boy, he doesn't disappoint, does he, Jim? He can put up some numbers. Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short game.
Second down here after that run play. Play clock's running down. Here's the handoff to LeGarrette Blount. They have the lead, but they have no running game to speak of to this point. That may change here down the stretch, trying to take the air out of the football.
Yeah, you're going to have to run it some just to work the clock and try to get the situations in your favor, but maybe every once in a while, fake that run and get an easy pass to keep that clock moving. That's an awesome job by the offense picking up this first down here in the second half. They've got a big lead. It's not about scoring anymore. It's just about milking that clock, and that is an art, and this team is good at it.
Brady's now completed. Patriots in the end zone. Jackson's caught his first touchdown of the season. And they've established a nice lead here just moments into the second half.
Wow, what a good job by the offense finding a way to score, but what a terrible job by the defense. No life, no execution, and now you just face a bigger deficit.
Watkins got a chance to return this one. Taken down at about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. The Bills talk things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8. Here's the give to LeSean McCoy.
McCoy's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
The Bills will set up. The 44 is the first down line. 3rd and 7. 2 hands on the football and has the catch. That's his 3rd catch of the day.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there.
Collins is in on the tackle. The Bills trail right now, and you wonder how much the running game stays a part of the game plan. McCoy's been shut down from his very first carry on.
No balance by this offense, like you said today. They can't run the football, but I've said this all the time. It's not always about just dominating physically and blocking up front. Running backs have to do their part. They have to make good decisions, and they got to break some tackles. Well, you expect defensive ends to get sacks because they come around the outside. But when you get pressure from the inside and the defensive tackle gets a sack, that's just an added bonus.
Loss of 2 on that play. Way through the 3rd quarter. It's Watkins with the catch.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
McCoy's handed the football. The ever elusive LeSean McCoy breaking the big one.
Jim, LeSean McCoy is one of the best running backs in the league, and he makes more people miss him than any running back in the NFL.
Here's the handoff, and they'll run it.
All you can do is your job, and that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
1st and 10. Takes it again. McCoy taken down. This time for 7.
What that run does, it just puts the offense in a good situation. So a good, positive run.
About to snap it for the 9th play of the drive. They bring in the extra tight end.
Second down, 3 for the first.
Right back to him. Shuns all over that offense and brings him down.
The Patriots defense is so fast and so powerful. That time of the run play, they just overpower the offensive line and they tackle the runner for a loss.
Third and 5.
Yard field goal attempt coming up. The kick is good.
Never take it for granted. When you're trying a field goal, a lot of things could go wrong, but good execution that time by the offense and a good kick. 3 points.
They'll take it at the 20. It's somewhat surprising to see, but you look at the rushing totals, and this part of their game has become less effective as the game's gone on.
I think the running back is starting to tire a little bit as you watch him run. Just doesn't look as determined as he was early in the game.
First down at the 20. Trying to power his way right up the middle.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
After the 2-yard carry, it sets up second down and 8.
Trying to beat the play clock. Blunt. That's a gain of 6. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
They call his number once more.
He's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
Games in the NFL can hinge on third and short. Who could pick them up and who could stop them? How about that play that time by the defense? They stopped the third and short run, and now it's fourth down.
Watkins has got a chance this time. They bring him down at the 41-yard line. That return's good for about 9.
The Bills put some points on the board on their previous possession, but it was just a field goal. They'll be looking to add some more right here.
Yeah, they will. And, you know, listen, you know, when you talk about touchdown drives, you have to kick a field goal. What does that mean? That means you failed on third down. Just not a good play on third down. They got to do better in that situation. If they do, that's going to lead to 7 points.
Second down and 5.
LeSean McCoy takes the handoff.
McCoy is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
Taylor's set. Empty backfield. We'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun. Makes the catch in open space. They have struggled on third down, but not on that occasion.
Nice job that time of the tight end. Makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
McCoy is brought down at the 21. The Bills will come to the line, trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. Here is the first snap of the final quarter. For a gain of about 5.
McCoy is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past it and picks up the first down.
First and 10. McCoy is going to take the handoff now. Touchdown!
Spent so much time in this league. Once you get in the red zone on the offensive side, all these different plays, knowing you must be efficient, you need to score touchdowns instead of kicking field goals. Well, you can feel good now because you got it in there. They wanted more excitement, more tension, more decision making, the second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This 2-point conversion
more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
Amendola's got it. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Patriots offense is on the field, hoping to erase the memory of their last drive, which was completely unproductive, a quick three and out.
Yeah, it was. I don't know if they can erase this defense. This defense is pretty good. We saw that in the last drive. They got good players, and they're pretty excited, so this is going to be tough on the offense.
A player is down on the field, and the training staff comes out, and we'll step aside for just a moment. Brady from the gun. The reception by Chandler. Tackle's made and the first down is picked up. That's reception number 4 for him.
When you can't hit the quarterback or put pressure on him, there's not much you're going to get done then. That time, quarterback had time and throws it down the field for another completion.
Brady goes to the Gronk. Gronkowski with the catch.
There is nothing like having a great tight end on your offense now. There's so many things you can do with them. Remember, they're in the middle of the field. They can go down the middle. They can go outside. They can go short. They can go across. They can go out. Tough to cover the tight ends in this league now.
Brady's now completed his last 7 passes. Let's get the injury report from Danielle Bellini.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Patriots team official. LeGarrette Blount's injury is lower body related, and guys, he will not be coming back in today's game. Back to you.
And a gain of 4.
Jackson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
The Patriots get set at the line, needing to get to the 46 for a first. Gets it out for the completion.
Zone defense doesn't work in the NFL like it used to. Good job by the quarterback reading that zone and finding the open guy.
They need to get the playoff.
Jackson's going to take the handoff from the eye.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
For this play, they'll go with 2 tight ends. Jackson's called on once again. Picks up about 2. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Jackson's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
The play clock's running down.
Brady's going to take it from the gun. The Patriots now move the chains.
Well, you get a couple first downs on a drive. It just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
It's Mario Williams who makes the stop.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The Bills' defense now is going to go nickel.
They better hurry to get the snap.
Gronkowski with the grab.
When you run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast. You have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
And the reception by Brandon LaFell.
You must be very creative in the red zone when it comes to the passing game. Formations, movement, do whatever it takes to give your players an advantage. That time they get a nice play call. They throw the pass and complete it for a good solid pickup. Good coaching on the defensive side. Everybody stays at home. They stay in their gap, and they hold that run to a short game.
Play clock's running down. And it's caught by LaFell.
If it was me, I would cover the short receivers and force this guy to throw it down the field. You're behind by a few points. You've got to try and force the issue.
And the kick is good for three.
That's a little bit of insurance for them with the field goal here midway through the fourth quarter, Phil.
Yeah, it was. That was a good drive by the offense and really some bad play calling on the defensive side. No wonder you're losing this game.
The Bills will be trying to make it three successful drives in a row as they retake the field here on offense, partner.
They got a great feeling from the offense so far. In other words, they're confident, they feel good, so you need to keep calling plays. It keeps the offensive players in a positive frame of mind. You do that, hey, I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down here and score again.
Taylor's alone in the backfield. First down at the 31. Watkins got it on a pass that had some heat. He's in the clear. The 20, the 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
Nothing like it for a quarterback, I'll tell you that. I loved it. Throw a little short pass and just root your guy on and watch him score a touchdown. Pretty exciting stuff.
Makes the PAT.
The Patriots will get it back in a moment. Still have a two-possession lead. Scores 38-28. He'll have a chance to take off. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Patriots are getting their offense geared up here. It's going to be interesting to see, Phil, how they react, because I know there was a letdown the last time they had it. They kept the ball for a long time. They picked up a whole ton of yardage, but ended up with only a field goal. So let's see how they'll react now.
Tim, I think you're right. I think they were disappointed in the fact that they executed so many plays and ended up with a field goal. Let's see if they can come out and look for something a little more dynamic. Well, they don't have to have those long drives. Look for big plays instead.
Trying to beat the play clock. Here's the handoff to LeGarrette Blount. That's a gain of 10. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
You're running back in this league and you pick up first downs and you don't fumble the football, I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
An extra tight end on the field for this one. Now first and 10.
He'll get it again.
And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field. He's now over 80 yards rushing on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Brown's there to make the stop.
Pretty predictable call that time by the offense. It's second and short. The defense is thinking one thing. They are thinking run, and they stop it.
2 minutes to go before this one's in the books. Back now in this one, and time is running out here in the fourth quarter. The Patriots have it at the 44. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. That's a timeout by the team. This will be a long one for three. No good. An empty trip for the offense. And he just couldn't find the mark on what was a very long kick in the first place.
Well, look, that was definitely not a gimme. And you got to look at it. Takes a perfect snap, hold, and a kick. And he just missed it.
First down at the 50. And he finds Sammy Watkins. Collins is there that time for the tackle. Second down, late in the fourth quarter.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout.
Launches it down the field. The ball is charred out of his hands.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Taylor's back in shotgun formation. They're going to get him here for a sack. The Bills call a timeout and are left now with only one. The offense is going to stay on the field now for this fourth and seven. They'll go for it on fourth down, late stages from the gun. Woods with the catch. Ryan's there to make the tackle. First down, pressure on every snap now.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most
all the way home just in time, a late touchdown.
While that touchdown edges them closer to...
We have a review coming from the booth. Touchdown will stand.
The Bills with the PAT to come. And the point after is good. The Bills need the ball back, so they're lined up for the onside kick.
Well, they had a lot of options to choose from on the onside kick there, because I've seen him in practice do many different onside kicks, but the attempt was just not good, and they're probably going to lose the game now.
Phil, this quarterback matchup has been a great one today, as both have put on quite a show.
Yeah, it's been a great matchup between the quarterbacks, and look, I think the league is loaded with really good quarterbacks. I'm tired of hearing people say, oh, the league doesn't have enough guys. Yeah, they do. There are a lot of good ones. Give them time, and they'll show it to you.
The line of scrimmage, the 43-yard line. Takes the knee. The Bills stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. This will be second down. Takes the knee. Seeing these stats, Bill, you really look at them and have to go, wow, because both teams are just playing so well on the offensive side of the ball.
I know that's what the fans are doing. They love these type of games. High scoring, a lot of action. They're having a good time. I know this, the defense, it's the other way around. They are having an awful time.
Takes the knee. They're set to punt it away now. It was a close one. And at the final whistle, what a win for that one team.
It sure is. What a thrill to win a close game in the NFL. You think about it, how hard it is just to get one win and how tough it was out there. And hang on, man, great feeling.
Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance, saying so long.